Hi everyone and welcome back. Today I'm going to create another spring card, but this time I'm going to add a pop-up element inside, which is so much fun. For my card today, I will be using the lilac dies and stamps. These are both by Stampendous, and I'm going to start by stamping some of these images on a piece of paper. Now I have a white cardstock here, which is slightly smaller than my standard card. I'm going to place it inside my Misty. I just have to remove that foam because I am using clink stamps today. And now I'm going to put the lilac on top of my panel. I am stamping everything with black archival ink, and I have also chosen one of the butterflies from the stamp set, and I'm going to stamp it on top of my panel. Now I'm not going to do any die cutting for the front panel of my card, and that's just because I am going to do something inside the card and I don't want to add too much bulk on the front. So now I am also going to stamp the leaves at the very bottom. And just because I want these leaves to appear as if they are at the back of my lilac, I need to do some masking. And what is great about this Stampendous stamp set is that they give you everything you need to do the masking. So you get this stencil that has all the masks for every image included in the stamp set, but at the same time you can use the negative space as well. I'm going to show you later on how I will be using that. Now I'm making sure that I put my mask on top of my lilac, but at the same time I'm making sure that I go just inside the black lines. So now I'm going to ink up my leaves and stamp them. I think I didn't get a perfect stamping at first, so I have to do that again. And now I am going to remove the stencil, the mask. And I have the perfect image to color. And now I'm also going to stamp that lilac and a couple of those leaves again with black archival ink on another piece of paper, and these are going to be die cut later on, and I am going to use them as pop-up elements on the inside of my card. And today I'm going to do my coloring again with distress inks and my finger dabbers, and that's just because I had all the supplies ready on my table since I made the card yesterday. So I am again using the two colors for my leaves. I'm applying first a lighter color and then I am going to apply a darker one at the base of the leaves. And these blend beautifully together. The cardstock that I am using is white cardstock by Simon Says Stamp, and it's the heavyweight cardstock. It's very smooth and it takes distress ink beautifully. I am going to add a link down below so that you can see which cardstock I use. To color these leaves at the back of my lilac, I will use this mask on top of the lilac, and this way I am going to add color on the leaves with a dabber and at the same time be nice and neat without adding any green on top of my lilac. I know that you can't really see where the mask is just because it is transparent, but I am just holding it with my fingers there. And I am also going to use the negative space from those leaves. I'm just going to remove them from the stencil, and this way I am going to make sure that I don't add any green smudges on my sky. So I'm combining the mask for the lilac and that stencil around the leaves. Of course you can use your favorite coloring method, but I just really love the look, that soft blending that distress inks give you. And again, I am going to work with the masks that are included in the set just to make sure that I apply peacock feathers all over my sky, but at the same time, I make sure that everything is nice and neat without adding blue on the areas that I don't want to. So although you can't see them just because they are transparent, I have covered all the images with the respective masks. Now, if you are going to color each and every one of those tiny leaves with your alcohol markers or your color pencils, it's going to take forever, so I think that this method gives you a perfect look, but at the same time, a really quick solution. So I have applied my first lighter color, and now I am going with a darker one. Now, the trick to make your lilac look more realistic is to have at least a couple of shades of that color on your flowers, because otherwise it's going to look totally flat. Now, you can add some shadows on some of the flowers that are at the back, and you can do that either with your Fantastix, as I am showing you here, or you can use a paintbrush. So I am going to smoosh a little bit of ink on my craft mat. And then I am going to use my watercolor brush. Now I'm not working on a watercolor paper, so I need to control how much water I add on my paper. But this is a really quick method to add just a little bit of shadow here and there that doesn't take a lot of time. Now with the same method I am going to color my butterfly. I'm mixing up two colors, that's mustard seed and spiced marmalade. And if you have seen my card yesterday, you might have noticed that I am pretty much using the same colors just because they were on my table. After coloring everything, my front panel as well as all those images for the inside of my card, I'm going to grab my dies and I'm going to cut out everything. Again, these dies are by Stampendous and they cut out exactly where that black line is, if you take your time to align them correctly, and you don't get that white border all around. But the way I have colored everything, just because I am going outside the lines, even if I don't cut everything perfectly, even that white border is not going to show because I have covered it up already by being messy outside the lines. So now I have my panel ready, and these are going to go inside my card as a pop-up element. Now I don't know if you can see, but I have some smudges and a blob of color that my blending tool didn't work perfectly there. So I am going to cover up everything that I don't like with those clouds. Just to show you what I do when I am making something that I don't really like, I just cover it up with another element. Another way to cover up mistakes or smudges is to add your sentiment on top of that. So now I have already cut out those sentiments on a black and white cardstock, and that is a die by Simon Says Stamp that says hello. I passed them through my Xyron sticker maker, and now with a ballpoint tool I am going all around the edges. And now I am going to stick the white on top of the black one and make sure that as I stick them, I offset them just a little bit so the black is going to work as a shadow. This is going to help my sentiment to pop even more against the background. And the truth is that cards with flowers work for any occasion really, so I am just going with this hello die cut, but you can stamp your favorite sentiment. It can be for birthdays, for a thank you card, for anything. And as you can see, for today I made another spring card just to bring spring closer. So I'm sticking down my sentiment there and my front panel is ready. I just want to add a finishing touch to it, so I am using my Nouveau Crystal Drops. I'm always making sure that everything is working perfectly before I go ahead and add the dots on my card. And I'm going to add at the center of each flower. And I repeated the process for the lilac that I have cut it out, so there are dots everywhere. I'm going to put everything aside to dry, and I'm going to work on the inside. So this is my card base, that's a standard card that's 4 1/4 by 5 1/2, and I have cut out another one for the inside that is slightly smaller, just to create a border. Of course, you can use any color for the inside. You can use blue to be your sky at the top, or green at the bottom to be your grass. But I decided to go plain. I have already scored and folded that, but you don't really need to do that. Yeah, because I am going to use one die from this Popsessories fun die set that has many elements, and I'm going to link you down below to a video that shows you how you can use each and one of those elements. I'm going with the simplest one and the most basic one, which is going to create a base for sticking my pop-up elements. So this is not going to cut out all the way. Those things that stick out, those lines, are actually for folding only. So measure where the fold for your card should be and then place those lines just there. And what's fun is that you can slide it left or right so that you can add your elements on one side or another of your card. I decided to go at the center and I'm going to run it through my die cutting machine. Now you will see that once I run it through my Sizzix machine, this is going to score exactly where those lines are, and it is also cut out a nice thing that pops out of your card where you can stick your elements. Now you can see how it looks here, hopefully. Now I'm deciding where I want those leaves to be. I'm going to stick one on top of the other just to make one continuous element. And just because I want to slide them all the way to the end, I am going to use my scissors to cut out a rectangle that perfectly matches that thing that pops out. So now I can stick the leaves at the bottom. And of course, you can embellish the inside of your card as much as you like. I could have created a sky and a grass maybe at the bottom. I could stick butterflies on top, but always make sure that you leave enough white space to write your message to the recipient. And before you stick your pop-up elements to that column, make sure that when you close your card, nothing sticks out. My lilac here is quite long, so I am going to chop off just a couple of flowers at the bottom to make sure that when I close this panel, the top of my lilac is not going to fall outside of the card. Now I am going to apply some glue, and I'm not going to go all the way to the top of that column, just where that fold is. And then I'm going to stick my lilac on top. And this is going to pop up. I'm going to hold it in different angles so that you can see how it looks. And hopefully you can see the dimension there that your lilac gives once somebody opens your card. And when you close the card, notice how everything falls flat inside, so it's really easy to send in the mail. Now I have added some tape on this dimensional panel and I'm going to stick it inside my card. So the bottom flap is now attached to my card base and I am going to add some tape adhesive at the top flap, making sure that I avoid that rectangle that I have die cut. I really love pop-up cards. I think they add a fun element and a great surprise for your recipient. So I'm going to close my card base now. And by sticking the pop-up panel inside another card base, it actually hides that hole at the back. So now all that's left to do is to embellish the front of my card with a panel that I have created previously that matches perfectly the pop-up element that's inside my card. And that was the card for today. I hope you had fun and got inspired. And if you did, don't forget to leave me a comment as well as give me thumbs up on my YouTube channel. And if you haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel already, make sure to hit the subscribe button because this is the way to tell me that you love my videos and you want to see more. And if you want more inspiration, here are two more videos that I created a while back. Thank you all for watching.